And it's our desire to give your name the highest praise today. So we say,
good morning and welcome to the Daily Download. I'm your host, Dr. Darrell R. Pulley. This is the day the Lord has made. We are rejoicing and we are glad in it. Thank you so much for being a part of the Daily Download, where the Lord daily loads us with his benefits. I'm telling you, today is already loaded. It is already jam-packed with the lessons and the blessings of God. And my heart and my mind are open to receive all the good that God has for me. And I am praying with you today that your heart and your mind are open and receptive to divine unlimited ideas. I'm telling you, I'm back from Israel, and I'm here to share with you this month of February, the impact that the Israel experience had on me. First of all, let me thank every person who invested in the Israel experience, because we would not have been able to have that experience without your prayers, without your support, and without the seeds that you sowed into the Israel experience. So this week, I'm going to talk to you about the most powerful impact that I experienced in this wonderful Israel experience, and that was on the Mount of Beatitudes. And our backdrop scripture for today is the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 5, chapter 6, and chapter 7. That's right, I said it. Chapter 5, chapter 6, and chapter 7, which is the Beatitudes. As my Sunday school teacher used to say, the attitudes that better be in you. So Jesus, on this Mount of Beatitudes, he talked about his manifesto. He laid the foundation for his ministry and exactly what it was going to be about. And so as I begin to ascend to this Mount of the Beatitudes, I begin to feel the presence and the power of God as I went up to this mountain. I felt like one of the disciples that left the crowd below and went and ascended up into this holy mount. Now, what made this so significant is that the Catholic Church was celebrating the Feast of the Beatitudes on the exact Sunday that I went there. People, pulley point number one is people from all over the world were on this Mount of Beatitudes. I mean, black people, white people, Asian people, Hispanic people, people from every nation had come to the Holy Land for the Mount of Beatitudes celebration, because they believed that that was the actual day that Jesus ascended to the mountain to give his Beatitudes. So that what made it so powerful, pulley point number one, is there were people there from every nation. Let me tell you, it is important that we learn to embrace all people, regardless of race, religion, culture, ethnicity, family dynamics, socioeconomic status, orientation, educational level, that we are in settings where people are from all different walks of life and diverse. That makes for us to have a powerful experience. Can you open up your mind where you can deal with people who are different than you, people that don't look like you, people that don't speak your language, that were not raised in your country? So what made it so powerful is there were people there from all over the world. Pulley point number two, what made this Mount of Beatitudes experience so powerful is there were priests there. Not only were there people there, but there were priests there from all over the world. The job of the priest is to bring God to the people and the people to God. There were priests there, and they had on their garments, and they were there with the people celebrating and leading them into worship and praise and thanksgiving to God that Jesus actually spoke the Beatitudes. You can tell when something is believed to be the words of Jesus because you find it in more than one gospel. It's not just in the Gospel of Matthew's, but these principles that Jesus taught on the Mount of Beatitudes are found throughout all four of the Gospels. And so the priests were there, and they were there leading. And God is calling us to another higher dimension of leadership. I'm calling for leaders, not to just lead by words, but to lead by example. Where are my priests today? The people who are leading God to people and bringing people to God. Where are the people today that are setting the example and setting the tone for the people? Where are my priests? Pulley point number three. What made this such a powerful experience is that the principles that Jesus taught on that mountain thousands of years ago still apply today. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. God is still calling us to have pure hearts. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. God is still calling for peacemakers today. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. God is still filling us with the hunger through the word and quenching our thirst through the fellowship of the Spirit. And so these Beatitudes are principles, kingdom principles that we can live by today. And that made that experience so powerful that the principles were in all different languages, that it wasn't just in English, but every language known to man had these principles in their own language. It was a powerful, power experience at the Mount of Beatitudes. And I'm inviting you today to ascend to the Mount of Beatitudes, to come to a higher place in consciousness where you know that you are functioning and the person that Jesus was, you are saying what he said, you are doing what he did, and you're living by the principles that Jesus established. Thank you so much for being a part of the Daily Download. I'm your host again, Dr. Darrell Pulley. And remember to share this with somebody else. Like this on your page. Invite a family member, a friend, a neighbor, a coworker, a classmate to share this message along with you. And remember, we'll be back tomorrow morning at 6:30 a.m. giving you another dimension of the impact of the Israel experience.